a secondary impact, but I think getting good candidates elected depends upon having a level playing field. It depends upon having a fair system. It depends upon having citizens throughout the country and throughout the state exercise their franchise. That's not happening today, and so very often we see what appears to be an election that might go one way and some might go the other because somebody put the finger on the scale. But I think our job as citizens is to try to make sure that we establish such fundamental abilities and with the levers of it. Frankly, I'm in our outline of the money program. We're not trying to limit the amount of money. We can't do that in our citizens' money. But we are trying to say we have a basic right to know where it comes from. We have a right to know who that is, who it is. A corporate or individual is trying to dominate our elections using phony right now, or using phony intermediaries to hide the ball. I think if we can make damage on that, make sure that the system is as unfolded and as impartial and as transparent as possible, the results will be what we want.
Now, in the break, so we have some of the most interesting conversations always, telling us your observations of actually how Russia muddled with Alaska.
Well, absolutely. I mean, the fact that they went in and spread forces alive and Hillary was critically ill, obviously, that was one of the three major personally probably called that false news, except that it helped him, and therefore it wasn't false news. I guess that's...
And the point he made about that was everybody didn't have to believe it. This election was won with 70,000 votes in three upper Midwestern states. You only had to move a handful of votes.
We knew that that particular troll message was seen by 30 million people. So you're right, all you had to move for 70,000.
If there's 2% believed it, that changed the result of the election.
And here's a problem that's a challenge for a democracy. We do definitely have to have some way of verifying the truth. And maybe that's a job for the university. So somebody has to stand up there and say, this is based on scientific method of whatever impartial basis you want. I think if just about everybody else wants to know, okay, what are the standards? And how do we know if something is totally
wrong? A lot of that's hereditary with what we've been talking about with the dark money issue. If you just knew who it came from, if you could identify the original source,
then you could evaluate the way a voter evaluates a witness at trial. If you have a voter change your algorithm, this is what they do. A voter today doesn't have an image right. It's a bad issue. That's the way the system operates.
And there's always a shell.
Yeah, I mean, if you really want to run